good morning, everyone. How are we doing today? Good, good. All right. So we kind of, their church looks a little different this week, doesn't it? Yeah. What are we celebrating this in these next few weeks? Christmas. Yeah. So Advent season, right? So Advent, it means to come. So we're anticipating, or we're recreating what it would be like to anticipate Jesus coming again. And like Pastor Todd mentioned too, it also has tie-in for the second coming. But so this week and then the weeks to follow, when we talk about Christmas, who is the reason for the season? Do you guys know? Is it Santa Claus getting presents? Who is the reason for the season? Jesus. Okay, so I want you guys to repeat after me on that. Say, Jesus is the reason for the season. It has a nice ring to it, right? Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Jesus is the reason for the season. One more time. Jesus is the reason for the season. Awesome. So in that way, a lot of the things that we do to celebrate Christmas, it also points to Jesus. Now, Santa will give presents, yes, but Christ gives us the greatest gift. We're just way ahead on what I was going to show you guys. But this week, I wanted to talk about some certain things that we celebrate in Christmas and how it points to Jesus. So, can anybody tell me what their favorite part of Christmas is besides the presents, okay? So, what do we do on our houses and maybe on our Christmas trees? What do we do? We decorate them. How do we decorate them, Kinsley?
A tree,
yeah. What do we put on the tree?
Ornaments.
Ornaments, yes. And then what do we put around the house? And it lights up.
Lights.
Lights, that's right. So this morning, I wanted to talk about lights. Now I have a set of lights right here. You betcha. All right. So, do you guys have any of these on your bushes?
Not me.
I pulled this straight off of our bush, so. Yep, he says. Okay, so now I'm all decorated in lights right now. So in the Bible, Jesus says that he is the light of the world in the Gospel of John. So when he came into the world, he was a light. And what do lights do? They light your Christmas tree, right? So if you guys lost something in your room and it was dark, what would you do to find it? You turn on the light, right? It would reveal it, right? It would show it. It turned on the lights, that's right. And Jesus is in that same way. When he came to earth, he is the light of the world. He revealed to us that we are broken and that we need him for redemption. And also it has in the Bible in Matthew that Jesus calls us the light of the world. It says we are the light of the world. So when you guys go out to your houses or you go to neighborhoods at night, do you guys ever drive by and check out the houses?
Yeah,
is that fun?
You don't need
all the nice lights, yeah, all the pretty colors. That's right. Exactly. So, but do you guys really notice those houses that don't decorate, right? Yeah. Why does that stand out?
I decorated my house.
You did? Okay. Because they have no light, right? Because the light reveals who has light in it. Yep. You are ready for Christmas. I know that. That's right. So, in the same way, you guys, when you look at those houses and you see how lit up they are and how they stand apart and separate from all the other houses, that's what Christ calls us to do, so that we are the light of the world, that we are like those houses that stand out, and we reveal Jesus to those around us. So the problem is that, you know, when Christmas time is over, or maybe in the daytime, what do? We do, that's right. And so we kind of think of that way when we talk about Jesus too, that we only shine our light maybe on Sundays or at Christmas time. But
yeah, Yeah.
How long should we show our light that we are in Christ? Should we do that just on the weekends?
Yeah.
No? No, Rylan, you said no. When should we do that? Every day. We should keep our light on because we are not the light, but Christ is the light that's inside us. So keep your light on. That's right. That's right. So you guys don't keep your Christmas lights on forever. I'm not saying that. But just remember that you guys need to keep your lights on. Yes, help me out there. Oh, that was on your shirt. Okay. Let's remember to keep ourselves plugged into Christ, okay? And then keep our light so that it light shine. And then when people see us, they see Jesus, okay? Can you help me? Let's pray and let's ask God to help us in that. Let's fold our hands and close our eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for sending your Son, Jesus, who is the light of the world, who is the illuminating presence that shines and that reveals the hurt and the sickness and the despair of this broken world. And also reveals to us that he is our Redeemer, our Savior, and our friend. Lord, and as we celebrate Advent season, as we decorate our houses, as we decorate our Christmas trees, and we shine them in light, Lord, help us to remind ourselves that we are called to be the light. And not just on Sundays, Lord, not just around people that we know, but we are to be called lights to the nations, to everyone around us, and every day, so that when people see us, they see Christ. Lord, we know that we cannot do this on our own. We need to be plugged into your source, and we need to have the Holy Spirit in our hearts. So we pray that you give us ears to see, ears to hear, and eyes to see what you have called for us in this time as we anticipate Jesus coming again. It's in your Son's name we pray, and all God's kids say, amen. Amen. Ooh.